Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to make a wavy line in Illustrator like this, and then I'll show you how to make a bunch of wavy lines like this. All right, let's get started. All right, I'm here in Adobe Illustrator, and I'm just going to create new. We'll come up here to print and choose letter, and then we'll come down here to create. Now the first thing we need to do is draw a line. So I'll hit P on my keyboard to get to my pen tool, which is right over here. I'll click once, then hold shift and drag over here and click again to make a straight line. Now I'll hit D on my keyboard and that'll give me a white fill and black outline. I'm going to come over here to my stroke palette. If you don't see your stroke palette, you can come up here to window and then stroke, and it's right here. And all of these other palettes are available under window also. Okay, so let's just increase the stroke a little bit. We'll get back on our selection tool. And now we'll come up to Effect, Distort and Transform, and Zigzag. And you can see we've already got a little bit of a zigzag going on. I'm going to change this to Smooth, and now we've got a wavy line. So now I'm going to increase the ridges per segment, and we'll make the size a little bit, well, I actually like it kind of subtle, so this is good. Okay, so we'll say okay. Now I'm going to zoom in on this by hitting Z on my keyboard and just drawing a box around it. To get extra ridges that follow the same kind of path, I'm going to open my Appearance palette. So I'll come up here to Window, Appearance, and you can see here we've got a fill. We actually don't need this fill, so I'm going to remove it. But you should have a stroke and then zigzag right up here. By the way, you can always click on this to change the zigzag that exists. Make sure you're selected on it first, of course. Okay, so we've got one stroke, and now I'm going to make another stroke. So to do that, I'm going to get in this blank area over here and just drag this on top of that little plus box right here. Okay, so we have one exactly on top of the other. And now we'll just offset this path a little bit. So I'll go to Effect, Path, Offset Path. And now we can change the amount that it's offset. I'm going to make that white space about the same thickness as my black lines. So for me, that's 13 points. We'll say OK. And now we can do the same thing again. I'll click on that stroke and just drag this one down to make a copy. And this time I can just click the offset path here because it already has this offset path. We'll just make another one that's a little further out. And right now this is one pass. So if we hit Command Y or Control Y, we just see the original line we started with. Let's hit Command Y or Control Y to get back. I'm going to make a copy of this because I want to kind of clean up the edges. So I'm going to just click this and hold Option or Alt to make a copy off to the side. That way we'll still be able to open our appearance and edit the different sizes of strokes or maybe the number of waves and that kind of thing. But this one I'm going to expand, which means it will not be editable anymore. So let's come up here to Object, Expand Appearance. And now you can see when we zoom in, each of these has points and paths. If we hit Command Y, you can actually see all those. Let's hit Command Y or Control Y again to get out. Okay, now to get rid of these, I'm just going to hit A, which will bring me to my direct selection tool right up here. And I'll draw a box around them and just delete them. Same thing over here. I'll just delete these by drawing a box around them and deleting them. These are still strokes, so we can change the weight of them, make them smaller or bigger or whatever we want to do. If we hit Command Y, you can see the shapes that they are. We'll hit Command Y again to get out. And these are also all grouped. So anytime you click and move them, it's going to move all of them. So if you want to move them separately, you can ungroup with Shift Command G or Shift Control G on a PC. Now we can take just one piece and move it away from the others. And that's it. It is that easy to create a wavy line and then lines that follow that line. All right, if you like this video, I also have an account out on TikTok. And if you want to see teeny tiny little tutorials about Adobe stuff, you can follow me over there. I'll leave a link in the description below. Thank you.